Hi, I'm Andy Larson with Skinner Sights, and today we're going to be talking about the different sight systems for lever-action rifles and how to use them. Of course, I'm a sight manufacturer, so this is of particular importance to me. Basically, we have the notch and the buckhorn type sight that comes factory standard on almost every lever gun that's made. This sight requires that the bead on the front is settled into the notch in the back, that you align those two on the target, and then while holding them there, take your shot. That can be a little tricky, especially as our eyes get older. As our eyes get older, it's easier just to focus on one sight. That's where the peep sight comes in and why they call it the magic sight for old eyes. Here we have a front sight, still the same kind of front sight. In this case, it's a brass bead. It can be a flat top blade, or it can be a fiber optic. It can even be a crosshair and a globe, but the brass bead is the most traditional. With a peep sight, all you have to do is look through the hole. You never want to look at the hole. You don't want to try and align the front sight in the hole. Your eye will automatically do that. That's the magic part about the human eye. Also, by using smaller apertures, you shorten the depth of field so that you can have both the front sight and the target in focus at the same time. So when you use a peep sight, again, we look through the hole, all attention on the front sight, its alignment on the target, focus on that only, breath control, trigger squeeze, follow through, and your groups are going to be a lot better. Anything that draws your attention to the rear peep, whether it be a crosshair or fiber optic or a glowing ring or whatever, actually detracts from that eye's natural ability to center the front sight automatically in the peep sight. This particular peep sight is mounted on the bolt. As you can see, it travels with the bolt as the bolt is opened and closed, and it does return right back to battery. There's no movement. This gun will also shoot a little under 1 minute of angle. And so that's the magic of the peep or the aperture sight. Sometimes we want to mount an optic on our gun, like this Henry Long Ranger. This is the Henry Long Ranger in a 308, and it's capable of one MOA or better accuracy. And so it sometimes is good to have an optic where we can have a little magnification. This particular scope is the Skinner Sights 1-6x24 low power variable optic. It has a lit 1 minute of angle dot in the center, and it's been very good for us in the field. We've used it on antelope, white-tailed deer, mule deer, mountain goats, and all kinds of different things we've used this scope for. And at lever gun ranges, and in this case, we're talking out to 500 yards with the Long Ranger, it's been very effective. Notice that on this gun, we have it mounted in what I call our Skinner Express scope mount with integral peep. We've got a scope mount built in to the peep sight itself. It looks like this. Here's the peep in the back, and these are the rings which attach to the top of the base. And so you can remove that with a quick detach ring if you want to use it as a peep sight, or you can put it back on when you want to use it with a scope. It's very handy in the field. This is the Skinner Optics. It's something new to our line, and we're really excited about it. It's been effective, and we've been field testing them now for a couple of years with no issues, just success. I'm Andy Larson, Skinner Sights, and you can find us on the web at skinnersights.com. Remember, we're saving the world one gun sight at a time.